Hi there. In this video, we are going to be taking a look at these Romanian-built speakers from the 60s. I think they are 62 or something like that. Quite nice. Okay, so these are quite an early model, as you can see. Cast aluminium or magnesium frame, not really sure which of those two it actually is, and the date, maybe we can see it, 15th of December, it's 1962. So they are quite old, and I think here it's something like 18th of December, the same year probably when they were tested or something like that. And we can see here, is that a 70 hertz? I think they were testing the resonant frequency maybe. This one has 65 or 85 hertz, not really sure. The same year, 16th of December, 62 or something like that. Anyway, so these things, yes, they have some small flaws in the basket. This is from the mold itself. It's lacking a bit of material in there. I think the other one also has it. It has it in another area. But there would be no reason to throw away such a frame and melt it again just for a small defect that doesn't actually impact anything. No cracks or things like that. I saw in some German speakers from about the same period, they actually had some cracks from when they were molded, but they still used those also. So yeah, they had some limits to what they can still use even with defects. Yeah, they seem to have a protection plastic on the magnet itself, and the writing Electronica București on the plastic. For me, one of them is a bit hit in the surround area. I could fix it, that would be quite simple for me, but this time I'm actually not going to fix it. I'm going to keep it as is, because these are pretty old and I just don't want to deal with changing them, like maybe old coins or stuff like that. If you start to repair them, you just throw away the value. So as long as these things work and don't sound bad, I'm not touching anything. Yeah, I know, that goes against what I usually do with speakers, that I fix them the second I touch them. But yeah, anyway, let's continue and give these things a quick test. They should be, I'm expecting, highly efficient speakers, but yeah, you can never know for sure until you actually try to play them. So let me connect my under desk amp that will be getting audio from the Bluetooth from my phone. Yes, it's no way the ideal situation for this particular type of speaker to be getting its sound input from Bluetooth, but yeah, it's not really period correct. Anyway, so I'm going to test a few types of music on them. One that's absolutely not period correct, and one that's somewhat period correct. So let's see how it goes. Just wanted to add, I do not know the power of these particular speakers. It's not written on them. So I'm expecting under 5 watts, honestly. Quite sure under 5 watts. And the impedance, I think it's 4 or 5 ohms. It gives me a weird reading that I cannot interpret as being clearly 4 or 5. As for size, 25 centimeters by 17 centimeters. And yes, if you like this type of old speakers, I will have a bunch of them on my channel, so you can watch the videos. So let's give it a bit of volume with non-period correct music. There are some songs that are free to use, so YouTube doesn't give me any problems. These sound good. They are not as efficient as another speakers that I recently tested, some bigger German speakers, but they are still decently efficient, but not as efficient as those, and maybe not as clear as those in the sound they produce. But yeah, you could listen to this with a tube amp without any issues. You would be happy with them. So let me give it some period accurate sound for the moment. I like how they sound. They are not again as crisp as the last ones that I tested, but those actually really impressed me, so I don't think I have any others that will come close to those. But yeah, they are nice, good speakers. So now I will do something with a little program. Let me quickly show you what it is called. Audio tool, and it's able to give us something like this in blue, a graph of the frequencies this speaker produces when I use something like this generator with a logarithmic sweep from 30 to 20,000 hertz in 15 seconds. Not really sure if it has started. Oh, the volume was the problem. And yes, obviously, I will do this test when I'm shutting up and only the speaker is producing sound. And yes, these are not controlled tests. This is not a controlled environment. It's something. Anyway, that's the best that I can do with what I have. So let's get to it. Okay, I just want to tell you, I'm not a specialist by any means. I don't understand everything what's happening with speakers and how they actually are able to produce certain frequencies really accurately and stuff like that. Yeah, so take everything that I'm telling you with a spoon of salt, not with a grain of salt. But anyway, what I see here compared to the German speaker, this particular speaker, get down, goes higher quicker. So it's better at lower frequencies and stays higher more. So it's a bit better at higher frequencies. But it's not as flat right here in the middle. So it's not. It's able to handle a wider range of frequencies, but not as good or as linear. And the overall sound that it produces is not as clear as the bigger German speaker. But honestly, this graph for a speaker this old, from what I've seen on other speakers that I've tested with this particular app, I must say it looks pretty good and pretty impressive. So, yeah, there's that. So, up until 8,000 hertz, this thing is linear enough in my test conditions on my bench without a box enclosure, without any specialized equipment, just an app on my phone. But I test all the speakers in the same way, so the results at least are comparable a bit one to the other, but not with reality of good testing that somebody could actually do. So yeah, there's that. And now let's switch to the main camera, and I will do something that it's not normal for speakers like this. I will do an excursion test, but I will not push them. I will just give them a bit of volume up until we can see the membrane moving on video. But I'm not going to push speakers like this just for a test. It's, yeah, some people like to see speakers moving, so I also like to see it, so yeah, why not? Let's go. So, I tested the second speaker also, and this one is a bit off center. When playing it at a higher volume, it starts to rub. I will also put in the description of this video another one of my videos where I show you how I can recenter such an old speaker without removing the cone and stuff like that. Basically, just quickly, if I explain, I need to cut this thing because to unglue it, it's impossible. The glue is really old and stiff, so I need to cut it around here carefully, making sure debris do not go into the voice coil. Then I will shim the voice coil, and I will use something like, is it here? Yeah, it's here. This thing, foam guard from simplyspeakers.com. And apply it all over this. So yeah, the speaker will not look like it's looking now, but at least will work. And yeah, that will actually improve the life of this speaker because it will not be as brittle, the edge itself. But I hoped I didn't need to do something like this to such a nice old speaker. But hey, it's not working any other way, so it's, what can you do? You look at speakers, no, you listen to them. So if they are not usable as listening devices, yeah. So I will also patch up these things. Hopefully I will show you both of these speakers because I will do the same thing to this one. They need to be a pair. They need to look similar. So I will show again both of them at the end of the video, but that operation will not be shown because I already shown it in another video and it's basically the same thing. Okay, cut this thing. As you can see, here is where we are rubbing. When this comes up, right there in the middle. And on the other side we have a much bigger gap and some dirt in there that needs to come out. So yeah, shim that and coat this in that like we did to the working speaker, which is already perfectly centered. So this one just needs to dry up, and yes, the edge will be a bit darker when it dries, but it will not be white, it will be dark gray, something like that. So there's that. Many speakers come from factory with this kind of coating on them. This one obviously didn't, but yeah, it needs to be done. There is no other way to recenter this thing without maybe cutting this all around, who knows, but I'm not doing that. Okay, shimming the coil gap. Weirdly enough, it's so much off center that even if I would only use this thing, it would still center it. It's not even trying to touch on all the other sides. And I will also soften the spider itself by putting some 99% alcohol on it. It softens it enough that it allows me to recenter this thing and make it work properly. One last chance to see the speaker without the foam guard over the surrounding. This one is with it. It's almost fully dried. It's not looking bad. It's actually quite interesting at this point. And this looks like a more modern speaker, although that's not something that we want in this case, but at least it will last longer. So let's do that one also, properly shimmed now. So let's continue. This thing is starting to dry up. This is wet with alcohol. So yeah, hopefully it will be centered. On other speakers that I did this treatment onto, all was good, but who knows. Okay. Shims are out. This thing isn't rubbing anymore. I played it for I think half an hour, played the other one for about the same just to make sure that both of them are okay. Yeah, so the voice coil is centered. What we need to do now is glue that thing back in place and give it another play just to make sure everything is stable. But yeah, looking good at the moment. Okay, so as you can see, that thing is in place. I used this like it's some kind of plate or something like that. It's Uhu Patafix, the name of it, to lower it exactly where it needed to be and put glue all around it. And now we will let it dry, and that should be about it for this. And the second speaker is centered and has the scars to prove it. So let's give it a test, make sure everything is working right, and that should be it. Quite nice speakers. Sadly, I had to give them the edge treatment that changes the look, but actually makes them more sturdy for the future. But yeah, with old stuff like this, ideally you don't want to change the look, but it wouldn't be done in this case. And yes, it's working perfectly, so we saved it. Hip hip hooray. Didn't want to do this, but it had to be done. There was no other way around it. So yeah, I will get the volume a bit higher, so hopefully you can hear it working as it should. We'll be right back. Okay, so this has been it for this video. I like the speakers. They are not extremely clear in the sound they produce or accurate, but they are quite cool, quite old, and quite fragile. Most old speakers become fragile after so many years, so that's that. You cannot take these things and put heavy bass music into them and hope they will survive, because you are just destroying something that has a bit of history behind it. So that's about it. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video, in which case please give it a like. Check out my other videos, many of them audio related. And as always, see you in the next one. Bye. And as you can see, they are quite similar to other Romanian speakers from the same era. Links to these other speakers will be in the description of this video, obviously, if you want to watch them.